So, the area calms down significantly since these five are in a science ball and Anvil is knocked out cold.
But everyone's kind of mad, aren't they? Because I was whipping them around.
Oh, yeah. No, people are still kind of freaked out. People are running out of the club. Jordan, what did Gideon look like? What does Gideon look like? What does the club owner look like?
This Gideon or Gideon from my last game?
You did describe this Gideon.
Okay, so I imagine this Gideon being a little like the Gideon from the last one. He's a
multiverse.
A very thin, kind of gangly person with who's missing a lot of his hair, but he always wears these like thick, dark goggles and like a large trench coat, because he's sort of the supervillain version of... Sorry, I spit on you a little bit.
Yeah,
he's sort of the superhero version of Gideon from Dark Sun, or the supervillain version. He would argue against that, but people don't like him that much. But yeah, he has a trench coat, which inside he has, like, an enormous amount of, like... He's, like, sort of a tech supervillain, and he's got, like, bombs and various, like, gadgets that he's created, most of which explode in, like, some fashion or other. His hair is always sort of scorched and like kind of like stands up and goes back. Think like a Doc Brown kind of thing.
I'm thinking like steampunk villain terrorist Doc Brown.
Yes, that's like exactly what I'm going for.
All right. So in the hole on the second floor that you created, you see the four of you look up and you see, steampunk terrorist Doc Brown. Gideon. Hi, you four, I want to let you know, you're banned for life.
What?
Get out of here before I drop a bomb on you.
Wait, but I need
That's to, not a euphemism.
I need to talk to Red Dragon.
Oh, kid, he's long gone.
Motherfucker. Well, we still have his friend, Anvil. Anyway, so I try to say, hey... I may have left my jacket inside.
It's mine now. I'm keeping it. It's mine.
But, like, I customized it myself.
Don't care. Mine now. Go away. I will blow you up. That's not a euphemism. He pulls out... It looks like a cartoon bomb, but... This will explode. And it will kill you.
So I just, like, look... I don't look scared. I just, like, look... I'm just like
a
rock and I like
I'm just like Kevin, you can bedazzle another jacket.
You can bedazzle another jacket.
Don't bedazzle.
Leo kind of am I banned too? Yes. God damn it.
I feel like Ziggy kind of walks up and stands behind us, kind of like looking around, and I'm like I think you can go now, and then it kind of nods and just
that thing's banned too.
But it's
you're all banned. Know. Go away.
Double bird.
Oh, double bird. Huh?
All right. We're going. Come on.
So what are you guys going to do?
I'm
going to
say I really like that jacket. You like fit me.
Priorities. All right. So you got a passed out Anvil on the ground.
Well, let's take him back to a lair of some sort.
Yeah, let's take him back to the workshop. Maybe he and a six shooter can.
Should
talk.
We drag the mooks there too, or just like
no,
let them try to deal with themselves?
I think the mooks are probably.
Can Gaddis will rise again? Can Gaddis will rise again?
Shut up.
Okay, so I just pick up Anvil and like toss him, put him on my shoulders.
It looks really silly considering the size you are, but you're still able to do it.
Oh, and by the way, I did not bring Atlas to this club. I know, it's like we haven't mentioned it, but I had decided that I did not bring him because it would be dangerous.
Well, they don't allow dogs, so.
True. Mm-hmm.
Even service animals, because they're super villains.
One of those we don't have accessibility ramps.
Yes, Jack?
Okay, so I have two questions.
We're not making fun of the differently abled. I want to make that really, really clear.
So, question one. Do you have the rest of the playbooks on your iPad?
We can get them real quick if you want.
Okay, just because I want to look at the playbooks. Anyway,
I mean, we did have all of them, but someone destroyed the Protégé playbook. Also, you went through all of them?
Yeah, but there's no Doomed is not in there.
Right, because Mac kept her character sheet.
Yes. Which is the one that I need because one of mine is Take a Sanctuary from the Doomed playbook, and I don't know what that is.
Mine is Take a Doomed from the Doomed playbook, which is only the bad part.
And then I wanted to see their character sheets as well, see what moves were available. Well, but there. My other question, which is kind of a follow-up-ish, is... you kept saying that the next time I filled my potential drag, you were going to make me take Kirby Craft.
Well, okay.
Was that a real threat, or was that a...
Not a real threat. Here's the reason I wanted you to take Kirby Craft.
Yeah.
Because you have mentioned the firearm several times. You've used it canonically.
Right.
Basically, it would allow you to use it in combat in other situations. It wouldn't just be a flavor thing.
Okay.
It'd be it basically added mechanics to it.
I don't know if I want to add mechanics to it.
That's fair.
I just like it as a flavor.
All right.
It's nice.
Flavor?
It's nice.
Tell me what's your flavor.
All right, so where are you guys going with the passed out?
Also, as we would go over to him, I like lift him up, and I was like, yeah! You guys fucking see that? This is an A-list, this is like an A-list superhero villain thing, and I beat the crap out of him.
Charlie, the first thing on your head is, no he's not.
I consider him a pretty big deal.
I know you do, but like, to the fanboy in the room, no he's not.
I put him down and I just like smash my head on the ground again. I'm like, yeah, fucking swole.
Yeah, you really got him swole. Even though we tried to help you and you were kind of tearing apart the team again.
I wasn't tearing apart the team.
You kept saying that you didn't need our help. Like, the whole point of the team is for us to help each other.
Oh, come on. You have had like 3 fights where you have told us not to intervene because it's an elemental thing.
No, I haven't.
You have! We've been there!
All right, kids. Am I going to have to pull this car over? Look. Everyone's an asshole in this equation. Can we sign off on that?
No. Because he's a bigger asshole.
Look, let's get Anvil back to the hideout, figure out what he knows, and then we're gonna let him go, okay?
That's fine! I just had to prove I could beat him. And I could!
Like I said at the start of the fight, I wasn't disparaging your abilities, but we gotta look out for each other. And I'm sorry if that hurt your feelings,
It's not Ted. About... feelings, okay? I need you guys to have a little faith in me sometimes, all right? When I say I can handle it, and especially when there's another threat going on, I want you guys to know I can handle it.
It's not about you handling it, and there wasn't another threat involved when we first started. So if you had just taken a step back and talked to us, maybe this would have went differently.
You know what? Sometimes there's not time to talk. When there's a giant metal-faced supervillain who is attacking you constantly and has already broken your face a few times, you stop talking.
Kevin, do you have a response to that, or are you just kind of like...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Look, guys.
Awkward walk home.
Look, guys, that was my fight, and I appreciate you were just trying to help me, but sometimes you've got to let me prove myself, okay?
All right, Ted. We'll back off. You do you, okay?
That was pretty cool, right?
Oh, we're not giving you that.
No, not at all. Not even in the slightest.
But I was really cool, right? Did you see the chain thing?
Is there terror in your eyes when you look at me?
Yeah. Well, I heard a team move.
No, I think the chain
I do not
thing
see you as an
cool.
Evil.
Well, that being said, I try to do mine organically, and
well, that you try
never
to
get one of the reactions I'm supposed to.
Right after we all fought with you?
Yeah, what do you mean?
You asked us if that was cool after we were like, that wasn't awesome,
but
man.
Is it cool is not what I'm trying to go for there. It's just you have to share a celebration.
Okay.
I thought I had saved my Google Drive, but I don't.
I do, thankfully. Mm-hmm. Just had to download.
Yeah.
So yeah, I feel like it's an awkward ride back to the
It's a super
workshop.
Awkward ride, and you don't even have a pug to distract you guys.
Yeah, and you both are like weighing down the back of the firearm real bad.
I'm regular sized right now.
Oh yeah, well he is, so.
And there's nothing good on the radio, so.
No. NPR is not even interesting right now.
Well, it's
or most
pledge
of the time.
It's pledging on NPR, so everything's just like,
And I left my phone in my jacket.
Whoops.
Oh.
Amateur mistake.
Okay.
All right. You guys get back to the workshop. Jonas is there, fully clothed.
Good. Pain in my ass.
Okay. All right. I'm going to throw it, and you're supposed to catch it, all right? And that. Thump.
Who is Jonas again?
Six Jonas shooter. Is six shooter, a.k.a. your dad's boyfriend, a.k.a. currently Jack.
Your new dad.
Jonas, sit down. Stop playing with Atlas.
Come here, Atlas.
What'd I do? Oh, got, shit, hi.
Yeah, we got somebody for ya.
Well, knock me down if it ain't Amber.
I'm carrying him in a, like over my shoulder.
Hey,
like
you're
that.
Normal again.
Yeah, I probably won't last that long.
First thing I do is I come in without a word and just fall face down on the couch.
That happens a lot at this place.
That does happen a lot. You have like a specially designated couch
yeah.
for that.
Yeah.
Super smooshy.
People try to deal with things. Or nap.
It's the nap slash emotion couch.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, Golden Arm got so sick of it, he eventually made a passive-aggressive little sign. He hung on it.
Oh, he's so passive-aggressive.
Well, he's still in the hospital.
I know.
When did you visit him?
Look, we've been busy.
Uh-huh.
Visiting who?
Golden Arm.
Okay.
His mentor, former elemental.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's still an elemental.
He's still an elemental. He's just in the hospital.
Right. He's just retired.
Yeah. He's retired.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Am I napping? Am I dealing with emotions?
I don't know.
Who knows? Even Kevin doesn't know.
Even Nicole doesn't know.
Yeah.
While the three of you are dealing with Anvil, you kind of feel, it's not a kick so much as someone's like nudging you with a foot on your shoulder.
And still face down, I go, what?
Thought maybe we should talk.
I'm napping.
No, you're not.
Well, no one can tell, so.
You're talking to me, you're not napping.
I'm talking in my sleep. And then I annoyingly, like, sit up. What do you want?
I owe you an apology. He's like trying. This is obviously something he's rehearsed, but he's forgotten every line for.
I look at the hand and I'm like, do you want a high five?
No, I was hoping for a handshake. No, look, kid.
That's not what I do.
I was mad and I said some shit to you I shouldn't have.
And Chaos Lut just sort of thinks for a second. I haven't even been thinking about that at all. Thanks. Thanks for apologizing. Sorry, yeah. I'm just like dealing with some things.
Now, I know I'm the last person who gets asses, but anything you want to talk about sort of things or?
Awkward stepdad conversation.
Not stepdad yet.
And let's just say, Kevin, waiting for someone to say that. Just anyone to say that.
Anyone, any port in the storm.
Any person at all. He lets go of everything. He goes, Queen Bitch kissed me and then I kissed her back, but I don't feel anything and I'm scared and I don't know why.
Well, shit, maybe you just don't like her.
What do you mean I don't like her? She's crazy cool.
Yeah? So is Skeleton Key.
Who is Skeleton Key?
Oh, yeah, you weren't here for
Skeleton Key. Skeleton Key is a 1950s themed cat burglar who kind of dresses up like a pinup model who can open doorways.
Oh.
That's like her superpower.
She's actually really cool.
She's really fun.
She's dope.
She has a cafe.
We liked her.
Yeah, everybody's got a crush on her.
She can come back.
Michael kind of wants to marry her.
Okay. Then I'll say, like, yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, Skeleton Key is cool, but she's not, like, it's not, like, my type.
Oh. Oh. You know, I was about your age when I figured out my type.
did you say it like that?
Yes.
Of course you did. When I found out my tag.
Tap. There's going to be the hand emotion and everything. My tap. Shit. God damn it. I just wanted to apologize on my goddamn day.
You didn't expect to be helping me.
I love how much. I love how much Jonas has just adapted to living in. In the shop.
Are you kidding? This is like the first place he hasn't had to pay rent that didn't have roaches or like 16 other villains living in it. Yeah. This is great.
If
he wasn't wanted by one of the most dangerous men in the world and his boyfriend wasn't in prison, he'd be so happy.
And he put up such a fucking fight. He should be thanking me at this point. But he won't because he's a dick.
Pretty much, yeah.
Correct.
Nail on the head there.
So I guess I'll just ask Jonas. Like, well then, how do you know exactly what it is you want? Because you convince yourself that you want something, and then suddenly it's not what you thought it was? How do you know anything?
I don't know shit. Kid, anyone who tells you they know what they want is a fucking liar. You just kind of roll with it. Find something you do like. Look, I'm really not the one to give life advice. Like, I've been in prison so many times.
Yeah, but at least you know who you are. Anyway, face first, down onto the couch. And then I'll say...
You want a beer?
I'll say, yeah.
Cool.
And then I'll say, hey, face first down. Thank you.
No problem.
That was nice.
Yeah, I just wanted to have that,
that
little
was
scene.
Nice.
Yeah. So the three of you have. What have you done to Anvil exactly, apart from steal his teeth?
I feel like we would have restrained him as best we could.
Yeah, I checked him into the logbook.
So what I think we should do is take like metal beams.
Golden Arm's like, hey, if you keep bringing people down here, you gotta like check them in so I know who's living here.
You know, you have like a little binder with like age, check-in time, check-out time.
Superpowers.
So yeah. What I think
Alias,
we should do.
All sorts of good stuff.
I think we should take metal beams and using your magnetic powers and my super strength, we kind of just like wrap him in it so he doesn't have any leverage, you know? Because that's the trick when you're super strong is to put him in a way that they just can't get leverage. On things.
Yeah.
Alright. So you make like a metal straitjacket sort of thing.
Yeah. Yeah. We keep capturing people. Like, that's questionably good.
It's not like you torture them or anything. Why don't you kind of let live here rent free?
Yeah.
Well, after we tortured him a little bit.
Was it really torture?
But
that was mostly Ember.
Yeah, that's true. Well, I think it was actually mostly Ash.
Ash definitely was the...
Yeah, Ember was just trying to take care of Golden Arm.
Yeah.
Because she's so amazing.
Okay,
she's
so yeah.
She's also the Fern Cock. She's great.
I love her.
But I guess we wrap him up and wait for him to, like, wake up.
Mm-hmm. It takes a little while, but eventually he comes to... Oh, you son of... Wait. Where are my... You took my teeth.
Ah, no. They must have gotten lost somewhere in the thing. You know, it was a crazy
battle.
Oh, don't
play that game, you little shit.
All right,
Jonas, what the hell are you doing here? Yo.
Hey, you're the one who hit me, okay? I just wanted to talk. Yeah. Look.
This wasn't part of the plan.
We weren't supposed to... You were not even who we were looking for, man. We were there to find...
You were there
friend.
To find Red Dragon.
Yeah. All right? Now, do you have any idea where he might be now? It seems like you guys were hanging out.
Oh, I know where he is. I didn't tell you guys shit, but I know where he is.
Hey, look, as unlikely as this statement is about to sound, we're working towards similar goals here.
Oh, I doubt that, kid.
Look, we just want to find the Green Inferno and get rid of it, and, you know, maybe screw Devereaux a little in the process. Tell me that's not an attractive option to you.
Oh, ain't that cute. Ain't that cute. I love it. I love working with kids. I also love getting my vasectomy. Yeah, sorry for lying. Look, I don't care. My job was to distract you guys. You got away. Good. I'm happy.
Who hired you, if that was your job?
Oh, Red Dragon.
Why did Red Dragon hire you?
Oh, he didn't hire me. He just asked me to do it.
So he didn't
We're
hire
buddies.
You.
Like, you do your friends a solid,
did,
I assume.
Did he tell you why? Stay face down on the couch.
So it sounds more like, Infinity War. I mean, guy knows a lot. I kind of figured, you know, there had to be a reason for it.
Okay, look, he said that the Green Inferno was alive, that it was lost.
Oh yeah, that's very true.
So how do we find it? Where did it go?
I mean, fuck if I know. Look, my job was to open the doors. Red Dragon's the one who took it. He's the brain, the brawn.
Okay, can I try and pierce the mask on him? I don't have a particularly good mundane.
Can I also quickly explain something gross that I'm doing?
Is this why your hands are under the table?
No. So I'm face down on the couch. My head is like deep into the cushion to where it's kind of like formed a divot. And I have the beer and I'm just kind of, instead of lifting my head and drinking, I'm pouring the beer into the divot and sucking it up.
That's so gross.
No.
It's a good couch. Why are you doing that?
That's not okay.
It's leather, right? So it's not going to seep in.
I did not say it was leather.
You did not say it was leather.
I'm picturing like wool.
Yeah, it is like a scratchy fabric
couch. I was picturing a leather, plastic vinyl maybe.
Nope.
Well, it's happening, guys.
Nope. So you're just watering the couch with beer.
Hey, Kid Ocelot. I mean, not Kid Ocelot. Chaos-lot is that's dealing with
is that what the case stands for?
No. K stands for Kevin. Anyway.
Yes,
I'm Kevin Ocelot.
I just wanted to get that in there real quick. You could go back to what your
case stands for Kevin.
Ammo just kind of looks and goes, oh, that's nasty.
K stands for Kevin.
I'm dealing with some things.
Hey.
Look, my friend here kind of doesn't care for you very much after the little incident we had at the bomb, and I'm getting pretty tired, so I might just leave and see what happens when you two are left alone.
Good cop, bad copping now?
Sure, yeah.
You're cute when you lie.
Okay, I want to try and pierce the mask.
There's a certain level of grossness to that statement.
Of course, yeah.
Very uncomfortable.
I want to try and pierce the mask, and I can talk to him like, look, we got off on the wrong foot, okay? Now, you remember me when I walked in, I don't normally look like this.
Nope.
And you clearly have dealt with some of the same things I have in this. So I get that when you have a friend, when you have someone who's on your team, who's close to you, you've got to protect them. You've got to keep that part, because for people like us, it's hard to find people like that. But what we're doing right now, believe it or not, is trying to help all of us, okay? I was possessed by the Green Inferno before. So we've got to understand what this thing is, because even though it's gone,
so
I don't think
too.
It's really... See what?
Little green guys, you see him too, right?
Oh my God, it's not just me.
Oh.
Oh my God, I thought I was going crazy.
Yeah. I mean, I don't see him. I was only possessed for a little while.
Look.
Red, all the time.
I don't think it's gone, okay? I think there's still part of it that's inside me, and I need to talk to Red Dragon. We all need to talk to Red Dragon to figure out what the fuck is going on.
Now I have to ask, were you possessed because you've done some bad shit, or were you just wrong place, wrong time?
I have to assume it was wrong place, wrong time.
You'd be surprised.
Wait, are you saying there's some sort of punitive thing at work with the Green Inferno?
Buddy.
What do you mean when you say do bad things?
And I yell, what does punitive mean?
Jonas
tell you later.
Jonas is kind of looking up on his... Wait, my phone don't work down here. God damn it.
Wait, can I roll to pierce the mask to see if that helps?
Yeah, go for it.
Nope. 4! Not very good.
Mark potential.
Okay.
Is that your fifth?
Yes, it is.
Everybody's leveling up. I'm actually one away myself.
Quick question. How many advancements have you guys taken?
This is my third.
Three.
I've taken four.
Oh, you're taking four.
Because my last one, I rearranged my labels and I added one to a label.
Okay. Instead.
So after you've done five, you can start doing the lower list.
Yeah, you get to start taking the advancements.
I'm taking Moment of Truth for my next one.
Also, just a quick announcement, Sci-Fi T-Rex, I see that. We will be doing that soon, I promise.
What are we doing soon?
We'll I'm going to take another move from my playbook, and I'm going to
also
take...
Also, Sci-Fi T-Rex, now I'm picturing the old cartoon and toy line Dino Riders.
Dino Riders.
I'm taking the move not human enough, which means when I directly engage a threat in a terrifying fashion, I can mark condition and choose an additional option even on a miss.
No.
Because I now think I have a particularly terrifying fashion available to me, which involves like the bone-breaking, shape-shifting approach to fighting people.
All right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's terrifying. I love it.
Yeah.
What a good... I keep getting this weird inkling that you want Swole to become a villain one day.
No, I don't particularly imagine him becoming a villain. It is though I see Swole's eventual path being accepting himself as Swole instead of totally working towards his natural inclination to try and become a regular person again.
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it. Mundane versus freak.
Yeah. It's more like I see him eventually embracing his like freak element instead of kind of being ashamed of it a little bit.
Dang it. I like that narrative.
Yeah.
I like it too. Look. It's okay. So you failed the roll.
Uh-huh.
You have no idea if he's telling the truth. I mean, you don't think he's necessarily lying, but you don't think he knows that much to begin with, and he doesn't seem to be willing to give you that much information anyway.
We're getting nowhere.
Hey, Anvil. Cut a deal with you. I will remake your teeth if you help us. Mm. I will actually make you a whole new set.
A whole new set?
A whole new mouth.
For some reason, I picture Anvil looking vaguely like Danny DeVito, but huge.
Yes.
See, that's actually pretty... I like that.
Yeah.
Anvil is like a giant Danny DeVito with the Jaws mouth.
But especially Danny DeVito from It's Always Sunny.
Yeah.
You know what I imagine? Ugh. Do you guys remember Street Sharks?
Mm-hmm. I was also picturing that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was like those weird toys that were just like
tangent.
Big
Have you
sharks
seen the promotional video of Vin Diesel? From 1994,
yes. Street Sharks.
Yeah.
He used to sell what? Toys.
Yeah.
Oh, he sells Street Sharks.
Yeah. Street Sharks.
I have seen that.
No. Yeah.
It's great.
That's amazing.
Pretty beautiful. Amazing.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Vin Diesel's a superhero in this universe.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and it's just Vin Diesel.
Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't have to be anything else.
No. Yeah, he's just himself.
Same with The Rock.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Vin Diesel is better.
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
I love The Rock. Anyway,
I'm making a mouth.
Whole new mouth. And there won't be any, you know, there'll be special features to it. Won't be anything that's...
No. I don't want that.
Okay.
I want silver. I've had black for about 7 years now. I want silver.
Done.
All
but
right.
You have to help us.
Okay.
And you'll only get them when the mission is complete.
All right.
I whispered to Charlie, I'm keeping the tooth I got, though.
Yeah, you can keep the tooth you got.
Okay. Look, Red Dragon's not like the rest of us. He's smarter. He doesn't have a hideout. Personally, I would have gone with the abandoned theme park somewhere south of Highland, but, you know, that's just me. We used to work out of an abandoned steakhouse in Tenebrae. Brought to you by Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Yeah, love it.
We have the steakhouse to downtown. Details forthcoming.
Wait, where?
It's in Tenebrae?
It's in Tenebrae. So.
It's not abandoned anymore.
So it's Jurassic.
Huh?
It's one of the details. It's not abandoned anymore.
Oh, it's not abandoned. It has currently been refurbished.
Yeah. Wait. So it's Jurassic themed. It's got dinosaurs.
No, that was the name of the user who.
Yeah. Oh. Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Yeah.
Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Was it an Outback Steakhouse, and then it wasn't an Outback Steakhouse, and now it's back to being an Outback Steakhouse?
No, it's fancy.
Does anybody remember?
It says. I guess
it
could be.
What's it called?
What's not fancy about Outback Steakhouse?
Can we just make it Jurassic themed?
It's a fancy Jurassic themed steakhouse.
Yes,
okay.
It is.
Just for Nicole.
The past is well revered in this universe.
They actually serve genetically cloned dinosaurs.
They do have dinosaur on the menu.
The not that long ago past, because there was a whole thing where a bunch of dinosaurs were all over the place.
And did we decide on a name or anything?
He did not provide. Did he provide a name? Oh, here we go. The Tyrant Steakhouse, up and coming popular steakhouse that secretly serves people on the menu.
That wasn't supposed to be. That was secretly.
I didn't hear anything.
I'm sorry.
That sounds like my pilot.
Not share that.
That sounds like the pilot I
wrote. All right. Well, we can't repeat it.
No, someone tell
me.
No, it's just people know it.
Watch it on video on demand, available on YouTube.
It's called the Tyrant.
The Tyrant Steakhouse.
Tyrant Steakhouse.
I like that.
And it's Jurassic themed.
Steak Semper Tyrannus.
Yeah. Wait. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I can
look.
I wrote a pilot that is about vigilante cannibal butchers.
Dude, keep that up, please.
It's a comedy, naturally.
Of course. It's a family comedy.
Yeah, sure. I sent it to you.
Disney.
I liked it.
It's on Freeform.
Yeah.
Disney.
All right.
I made it all fancy.
I love
Actually,
it.
I just made it. Because I got me that nice handwriting.
Yeah.
All right. So, listen. We used to do our business at Tyrants. You know what that is? It was abandoned, got rebought by some dude.
Oh, no, somebody reopened Tyrants?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in my neighborhood.
Hmm. Hey, you rich.
Isn't there dinosaurs there?
I don't know.
Okay, I sit up. All right, guys, I'm totally down to go.
I imagine it's kind of like a dinosaur type restaurant that's like a la Rainforest Cafe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's that's definitely animatronic dinosaurs. It's classy.
See, I feel like there's really genetically modified dinosaurs there.
Well, they do Jurassic have, World they have that on the menu.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I don't want to enslave them. I just want to eat them.
Yeah.
Right, but it's played on a four-string quartet.
Yes.
So it's classy.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, yeah. We used to do our business there. Apart from that, we're up a creek. He knew you guys were coming. He asked me to distract you. And frankly, I've wanted to fight this one for a little while. Even he's a big fucking liar.
Oh, come on.
Hey, no one said you could shapeshift back to human, all right?
Hey, I
look like this all the time.
Yeah.
I'm like uglier Danny DeVito.
Trust me, I can't, if I could make this happen all the time, I could. But I have no idea when it's going to happen.
Who'd you piss off?
I think that's pretty obvious, right? The same guy who everybody pisses off all the time. Fucking Gregor.
Did Kevin actually say God?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but keep in mind that he's drenched in beer right now.
You're taking a shower before you get
the crustiest of punks.
No, yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and say, hey guys, I'm just gonna jump in the shower. I take the cushion with me.
Why are you wet?
I don't want to talk about it.
No. Yeah, I go, no, look, this is just something that fucker Devro does to prove to me that every time I'm not like this, it's his fault. Okay?
I'm trying really hard not to laugh, buddy. That sucks.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of it myself.
Oh, I walk back out and grab another beer before I get in the shower.
Beer shower.
Yeah, shower beer. It's shower. Important. It's the mm-hmm. important part
I didn't know that was like an actual thing until recently.
I've never done it.
Oh, yeah, that's no, real
thing.
I don't know if I'd like it. I don't think I'd like it.
I like keeping those things separate.
Yeah. I mean, having a beer in the tub, that sounds awesome.
I'm not in the shower long enough to have a shower beer.
I could.
Oh, if you bring a beer, then you'll be in there long enough.
No, it's still just, because then my cats get really lonely. They wait at the door of the bathroom for me to finish.
Invite them with you.
No, like I've tried that, and they're fucking weirdos.
So the house I'm in right now has two cats, and one of them just like lives in my room the whole time. And so oftentimes they'll just close the door because I don't just want my door open all the time. And they've started doing this thing where the cat that stays out of my room will reach her paw under it, and the cat inside will like fight the paw coming under the door.
Oh,
the
dorms.
When I lived at home, all the cats learned how to open the doors. Not a joke. It was real. Hilarious.
We had a cat that did that, and it would set off the alarm every night. It was great.
One of my cats thinks that if he is adorable enough while I'm trying to put my shoes on, that I won't leave. And he is wrong every fucking time.
All right. That's funny. So anyway, he tells you Tyrants. That's where he knows Red Dragon hangs out.
All right.
Well, you guys have to wait until I'm done taking a shower and washing the cushion that I drenched in beer.
Jesus, Kevin.
On that note, I'm actually going to go ahead and call BioBreak real quick. Go ahead and do your plugs. I will be right back.
Okay.
Cool.
Plugs.
Spam.
Should we let him go? I mean, can we get into Promise not to fucking wreck the entire town and, like, let him out?
You get the feeling, like, if you got into Promise that he'd actually obey. He'd keep his word.
Okay. So, yeah, I'm going to be like, look, we don't want to just keep you tied up in our basement. All right?
Oh, no, I'm going to hang out with Jonas. It'd be great.
I mean, I guess if you want to.
I'm good. Look, let me go. Promise. Hell, you just impress me.
I appreciate it. Hmm. And as I said,
I'm a fan of some of your earlier work.
Thanks.
Come back in about 2 days. I'll have your teeth ready.
Good deal. Yeah. You guys lift the...
Unbend all the girders and stuff. We've got them wrapped in.
He waves Jonas, and he's out. And I will be back.
Cool. Oh,
Chipotle, man. Fucking Chipotle.
Hey, everybody. Follow me on Itchy Brained. Twitter, Instagram. Don't just go cross. Just cross it, okay? Twitter, Instagram. I post funny stuff. Although lately, it's not funny. It's very, very sad. Stuff you need to wake up to. Don't follow me if you don't want that. But I do post funny things occasionally. And at least on Instagram, they're pretty not political. It's just selfies and things.
Just saying, it's funnier if you're woke.
No, it's not. No, it's even more depressing.
I can't stand the term woke. It's so condescending. It's so self-congratulatory. That's my problem with it. It's so like, I've woken up. It's just like the fucking men's rights activists who call themselves red pillars and who are like, because that's the whole thing is like, oh, I woke up and I understand how things, they're saying the same thing and they're both so self-congratulatory.
See, I always saw woke as a term that you couldn't give yourself.
Yeah.
It's like a nickname. You can't give yourself a nickname.
But
or else
by
you sound
acknowledging
like an
everyone, like, oh, I recognize that person's woke, it's like saying you're woke. I don't know. I'm frustrated by it. I'm writing a sketch where I come into the room and I'm like, guys, you notice something about me? I'm woke, right? Like,
well, part of it,
I'm woke now.
Well, a lot of it also comes from the Black Lives Matter movement. So, I mean, it's not necessarily like a white term, and it's not, you know, it comes from that movement.
Don't
I don't care who's
it.
Saying it, it's heavily self congratulatory.
But don't appropriate it for your own means.
Yeah,
I'm
white
not
man.
Appropriating it for my own means.
You're appropriating it for a sketch.
What? No.
And you're also diminishing the word by doing that.
I think it's a lame term.
I mean, it was never your word to begin with, so
yeah, it's okay.
Be careful how you use it.
Everybody can
because
use
that's
stuff.
Something that white people tend to do. They will take something that was started by another group and then use it to the point of overusing it and then reject it saying that it was lame. Thus,
it's a cycle.
Yeah, thus just diminishing the people that originally came up with it.
Yeah, like throwing shade was actually a term that came from the Black and Latino drag groups in New York, in Harlem, and that was like a thing. And then it moved on to the rest of the gay community, and then it was appropriated by the Black community, and then it was appropriated by white people, and now it's like. Everybody's like, throw in shade, and all the queer people are like, but, all the queer POCs especially are like, but us,
well,
and it's...
I can't get behind woke, sounds like a cult term, and it's almost exactly the term that men's rights activists use too, they just use it slightly differently,
yeah,
and
well,
it's heavily self-congratulatory.
Don't
and
use
I
it.
I think there are much better terms.
What are you talking about?
Don't
woke.
Use it, or at least don't write a sketch punching down at it.
Mm-hmm. It's not punching down at the term woke. It's punching down at people calling themselves woke.
Sure.
And people use the term woke to like say they're like, oh, I can say things because I'm woke. And
I wonder how the chat feels about this. Because usually when I talk like this, people hate me.
I kind of don't care what the chat says about it.
They think Jordan has a really good Will Wheaton cosplay going on right now.
I've heard that before. People have mentioned that they said something. They were like, Jordan's like a mix of Will Wheaton and... some other.
You do inspire
sort of
me
nerd
to play board games
guy.
And tell you to shut up. So.
I play a lot of fucking board games. Mm-hmm.
Star Trek joke.
Shut up, Wheaton.
Yeah.
Shut up, Wesley.
But,
Wesley.
But yeah, there's, I don't know. It's just like, I don't use the word to like describe myself because it's like, I mean, it's, I don't think it's a word that I can use to describe myself. And, you know, it's, I don't even use it to describe other people because it doesn't feel comfortable to me, but it's a word that is important in the Black Lives Matter movement, so I'm, you know, they can use it, and that's fine, and, you know, I just try not to be an asshole.
We tried not to, but we got political immediately.
Very political.
Yeah.
Like, I was gone for 5 minutes.
This is what happens.
And now it's like, well, let's have a real discussion about the Black Lives Matter movement. So, like, okay!
Hey, there are, like... An issue that I never thought I'd have to face in my lifetime is whether it's okay or not to punch a Nazi. The fact that people are arguing that it is not okay is the problem.
Oh, no, I'm 600% pro
no.
Nazi punching.
Oh, fuck.
Holy shit,
are you okay,
Nicole? I was trying to get out of my seat, and I succeeded.
Yeah.
But no. Yeah, I am okay.
Are you okay?
But oh god, that was on camera. Wait, please tell me you have the camera facing somewhere else. All right. Well, somebody should GIF that.
Clunk.
You're not the only person who's done that.
Anyway, Nicole, I'm gonna go blow my nose again.
Okay, I'm gonna. I guess we'll just continue plugs and stuff.
Yeah, we didn't even.
No plugs happened.
Nicole's plugs started. Happened, and then we just stopped because it got sad and political, and so.
I run a great game here, folks.
Yep.
What you don't see is the producer shaking his head slowly and doing this.
Dom loves it. Dom loves it so much. Yeah, he shook his head at first, and then he started nodding.
Now he's a tentacled monster.
It's the California. It's the California. No, yeah.
Yeah.
No, which means
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. No. No. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then yeah. No means
yeah,
no.
Yeah. No. No.
And then yeah. No for sure.
No, he has a tentacle
means
monster.
Absolutely.
Oh man, I didn't know he had.
He's
tentacles.
Turned into a tentacle monster. Ah!
I knew this. I was gonna die.
Okay, so I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do my plugs. I'm gonna talk at that camera. So, Twitter, Instagram, and then I'm also still funding for my top surgery, which is February 6th. I'm in the single digit days till it happens.
Oh my God.
You can find it on GoFundMe. Jack gets something off their chest. I'm like over halfway there. But there's still time to raise funds. I had to put my, I had to do a deposit for it already. So it's happening. And I won't be here next week because I will be at a work thing. So the next time y'all see me, I will be barely moving. And
it'll be great.
It'll be great. And I'm going to be 10 pounds less. I get to lose 10 pounds in 2 hours. And I'm so excited.
Yay!
Yay! Wow.
All right.
I support that.
We all support that.
Yeah.
All right. So, you go ahead and let Anvil go.
Cool.
So, what do you guys do? Do you head to the Tyrants or?
I could use a steak.
Yeah, let's go. Let's Tyrants it up.
Yeah, my family's got a frequent buyer's card.
Am I still Reg Swole?
You're still Reg Swole.
Don't tell Katie though, okay?
Katie Vegan.
Oh boy.
She's trying.
It's like it's kind of been on and off for a while.
She gets
now.
Preachy, and I just assume not deal with it today if it's all the
she
same.
She a lacto vegetarian.
Yeah.
Like she's cut out eggs.
Oh, it's like Milo Ventimiglia. I looked at his Wikipedia today and that's what it said.
Well, I'm thinking
that's
like,
character
I'm thinking
kind of
like
said that.
She's lacto vegetarian, which means she doesn't eat eggs but still eats milk because she is a hard time giving up cheese.
Cheese. She loves cheese.
I'm trying to give up dairy products
all
right
day.
Now. Cheese
day
is very difficult.
Cheese, but anyway, yes. Let's go to Tyrants and see what's going on.
Tyrants.
All right. So you arrive there.
Wait, they leave. I finally come out of the shower with a cushion that's still soaked. I look at Jonas.
It's more wet now.
Well, yeah, but there's no beer in it anymore because it's just like all sopped out. Anyway.
I'm so glad I was not paying attention to whatever was happening.
It's basically just going to be a giant mold sponge with just, a month.
Yay, mold sponge.
I'm going to take it outside so it can dry out in the sun.
It's not, it's the middle that's of the night.
How. Just like leave it in the dirt.
That's oh, no, okay, no,
like,
I'll,
this will
I'll
make
throw
it, better.
It in the dryer.
Okay.
You're just ruining our...
I love that you're treating the shop like it's an apartment. It's not an apartment, but it does have a washer and dryer.
It does, and it does have a man living in there.
Canon.
He's not even really treating it like an apartment. He's treating it like it's an abandoned IKEA.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm doing.
It's all you know.
So I throw it in the dryer, and then
I lived there for like 6 months.
I looked up, and I think, wait.
Oh, shit.
Wait, where'd everyone go? To Jonas, I say.
He points towards the door.
Ah.
He's like reading a Nat Geo.
So I leave. But I'll probably arrive there 15 minutes after them, so that'll be fun for me.
We'll just go ahead and say you all get there at the same time. Public transportation, Hyperion Sea is really good. And it is one of the nicest steakhouses you've ever seen.
Yes, it is.
Now you, Mr. I have a frequent shopper's card.
Hey, that's my parents.
Well, tell me what it looks like in the inside.
It looks like it's super Midwest. which means that it's just like, it's really, like, it has a warm feeling inside. It's a lot of like dark wood, mm-hmm. and there's a lot of like leather, like red leather seats or pleather seats, and it's like, it's, you know, it's just like, it feels really, like, the feeling in there is very heavy, and then it's got a dinosaur theme to it, because it's,
and I just realized you're wearing your Jurassic Park shirt.
So
good job, sci-fi T-Rex.
Intentional.
Did you say?
And McCubsat.
I need Diet Coke.
So
I'd be having a stroke.
But yeah, it's Diet like.
Thank you.
But I would say it's like less like it's not super campy like dinosaur theme, but it's like it really feels like you're in fucking Jurassic Park, like you're eating them.
If Jurassic Park was real and fancy, this is what would be served there.
So yes. Westworld.
Yeah, it's pretty much.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
But with dinosaurs.
And yes. You four are wildly inappropriately dressed.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, we always. Hey, I took a shower.
Yeah, so you're still damp and wildly inappropriately dressed.
Yeah, but, like, I'm clean.
Because aren't we in our super suits?
Yeah.
Well, but my super suit is basically just jeans and a t-shirt and, like, a okay. Feet jacket.
Yeah, my super suit is a pair of leather pants that are kind of ripped, but I use safety pins to put them back together.
Mm-hmm. Mine's a red and white striped leotard.
Yeah, you stand it like a sore thumb.
Yeah.
Like a swole thumb.
But t-shirt that's been cut up, and I don't have my jacket.
But, like, the fact that people are staring at me for wearing something weird as a normal person is like, this is nothing. Okay? This is, like, regular stares. Right. I'll take it.
Get on my level. Yeah. The maitre d' comes up. Can I help you?
Of course.
We want a table.
I don't believe you're appropriately dressed for this.
Well, do you have a dinner jacket? I'll wear it.
Oh, excuse me. And I, like, push my way forward, because being tiny. Hi, Daniel. And I, like, hold the card and be like...
Do you really, like, does he have, like, a name tag or something? I don't
know
Daniel.
Well, no, I know who he is. Oh, because we're here all the time. Like, come on, man. We know who all the wait staff are.
Or do you, or do all of us?
I do. My family does. I say we, like, my family.
Okay.
And I go, hey, Daniel, can we please get a table? And I, like, hold the frequent buyers card. It's got my dad's name on it.
What is your dad's name?
Also,
his name is,
Illusions?
Oh, fuck, yeah. I
His
leave.
Name is Peter.
And then
Peter
I come back in a, like, what I think is a really nice suit.
Because Polish.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's very Polish.
Your mom's Korean, right?
Yes.
All right.
It's a lot of plaid. Just letting you know.
I was going to put you in like a James Bond outfit.
Yeah, but plaid.
Like a plaid tuxedo?
Plaid.
You come back in a plaid tuxedo.
Love it. I love it so much.
I'm thinking of like what a golfer would wear.
I'm a big fan. Charlie's a big fan.
That's
Jack's a big fan.
Pretty fucking cool.
Yeah, it's pretty punk rock, if you ask me. Anyway.
Is that a team move?
Oh, is it a team move?
You have not had getting into a restaurant is not a victory.
I would say so. I'm getting us a table.
Have you tried to get a table at Tyrant's?
Come on, Steven.
I don't like red meat. So, after some finagling and a... amazingly ugly suit.
I did bring Atlas this
it's
time,
not ugly.
Burf. Burf. I hope you process paperwork, because otherwise that dog is going right outside.
Yeah,
no,
I got
he's
it.
He's a support dog. Yeah, he's got his little vest
on. You don't even need to bring paperwork.
So the four of you would find yourself.
No, because he's got his little vest on.
Yes.
Doesn't he? Yeah.
That's a cape.
No, but he's got a vest that says...
It's a service dog.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Well, no, yeah, I think he's got a cape. I don't think he wears a service dog cape. But still, if you bring an animal into a place, and you're like, this is a service animal... they're not allowed to ask for proof that it's a service animal, but you are allowed to ask, oh, what are they trained to do? Mm-hmm. And if they don't have an answer for that, then you can make them leave.
So if you were to say, like,
the issues
and, yeah, if you were to say, like, I have seizures, and what they do is they do this, and they're like, dog's allowed in here. Mm-hmm. But if you were to say, like, I get depressed sometimes. Yeah. You're like, we all fucking get depressed sometimes.
Just gonna pause real quick.
Well, the thing is, you're not allowed to ask them why they need it. You just can ask what
Twitter,
they're trained to do.
Twitter user Fawquad.
Oh, hey, Fawquad!
Has posted
me falling out of my chair. And it was like a perfect cut, too, because it got me just in time.
That's amazing.
Thank you, Fawquad.
Thank you, Fawquad.
You need to show Michael that, because he missed it.
Yes, please.
Oh, yeah.
Make with the give.
So anyway, the four of you find yourself shoved at the table meant for two.
just gone.
I mean, I heard a clang. I looked over. You were like,
I was gone.
She's gone. On the floor. Just on the floor. We were having like a deep discussion too.
Yeah, like a real important.
We were gone
like 2
discussion.
Minutes, and suddenly it's like, well, my thoughts on woke and the whole Black Lives Matter movement. It's like,
nice. I didn't say anything about the Black Lives Matter movement. I just don't like the phrase woke.
Anyway, coming back to the story.